Okay, so before we start our lecture today about selecting which information system proposal should be picked and then built, I would like to see or discuss a bit about your timeline. So about your project management cases. Okay, so start with group one. Okay. So you have initiation here for 2 weeks. Okay, and planning. 3, 4. So it's 10 weeks for planning. Okay, so it's half execution. 10 weeks also. Okay, group one. You need to put more time for execution rather than planning, because with you have 10 weeks of planning and 10 weeks of executions, that's a bit too much for planning. Okay, there is no exact word or exact guidance on how long the planning should be, but in my experience, it's usually less than the execution itself. Okay, and when you look at the real execution in the field on the real system development, is usually longer than planning. Okay, so I suggest you to change that for the next assignment, because it's too long, I guess. Okay. Looking at the activities here for planning, for example, let's see. Create general project plan, giving jobs. You need 3 weeks just for this. This is too much. Okay. Creating workflow diagram, describe possible constraints is also too much. You should merge these two activities into one and get done with it. It's probably require a whole week or 2 weeks tops, but you can cover these two activities into just one. Okay, see the budget and also developing the budget, all this making present. This one making presentation to who? Okay. If you want to make presentation to client, just mention like this one. Okay, get the client approval, review it with the team project. And you do need review a week. Just for reviewing the meeting, so you can just do it immediately after the meeting or the next day after the meeting. It's just required just a day. Okay, so this is too much for planning. Okay, and for the execution, we'll discuss it in detail, but it should be on developing the system, and it will follow the system development life cycles like analysis, design, implementation, and so on and so forth. Okay. Any question? Group one.
No, sir.
Okay. So no. Fix that next time. Okay. So next. Oh yeah. Okay. The other doesn't give. So it is group four. Okay, I'll start. Stephen Kenji and Landrikus, what group are you in? Can't remember. Kenji, Landrikus?
Group 2, sir.
Okay, so you should put that in this report. Okay, so rather than looking up the group list, you can just put group 2 or group whatever. Okay, like the others. Okay, let's start with this. How long the 3 weeks for? Yeah, 3 weeks for planning. Oh no, sorry, initiation. 2 months for planning. Okay. 2.5 months. Okay, this is a bit too much in my. When you create project plan and workflow, you should also estimate the budget and resources. and all this, okay? Rather than doing this, 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 and this. It should be in one go rather than in separate activities, okay? When you create project plan, you also create budget and also identifying risk. That's an integrated process, not separated process, okay? Closing down, okay, that's fine with 2 weeks, but again, planning is too much. You should cut it down to probably 5 weeks or 6 weeks looking at these activities, okay, and put more time in execution. And again, execution should follow the system development life cycles. So you start with analysis, design, and end it with implementation. Okay, any question? Group two.
Officer, no sir.
Okay, good. Now then to group three. Again, group three, who's group three? No identification whatsoever here. No name.
Yes, Giovan and Maria.
Okay, so you should put identity. Okay, otherwise.
Okay, sir.
Look, if this is a real project, your report will be tossed to the bin immediately because there is no name, no identity. You know. People just read your report and say, who the heck is this guy? So they toss it to the bin and that's it. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, okay, again, planning. Wow. 9 weeks for planning. Okay. What did you do here? Job description. Now, job for each member. By each member, who do you mean by each member? What member?
So I think the member of the project, like its department.
What department?
So I like because we want to put the payroll, so we divided like maybe in the system at the system department and then the legals and then maybe the
you should specify that.
Oh, okay.
Okay, how many members? And if you mention about project management and you involve legal, you should be very careful because by member, I assume that it's the project management team member, which is third party, which is you, not legal, not the other. They are the users, not or stakeholders, not project members, project team members, sorry. So it's you. And 2 weeks just to create job description, that's ridiculous. Okay. Setting the budget 2 weeks. No. You should create the activity plan first. Where is it? I don't see activity plan. I don't see execution plan. I don't see project plan. Where is it?
Like so we put it in the fourth under six week in the procedure of the business.
Procedure of the business is not planned. Procedure of the business is a procedure. If we use the common definition that being used in practice, procedure of business is the procedure for applying travel. Procedure for requesting money. That's procedures. That's not plan. You know the difference between procedure and plan, right?
Yes.
So why did you put this? Okay. So
okay.
This is I will. Mean, I get. This is ridiculous. 9 weeks for executions. Okay. This is ridiculous. Unrealistic. Okay. So again, I don't just make my comment based on the numbers that you put, but also I look into the detailed activities that you put into your report. And judging by that, 9 weeks is too much. Okay.
Sir.
Okay. So.
Thank you.
Now, lastly, project group 4. Okay. Again, there is no 25. So 4 to 5 weeks, 5 to 9. It should be exact numbers, not range like this. And you didn't mention when. Is it September or October or where?
We'll edit that later.
When did you want to start this project? There is no. 4 to 5 weeks, which one? 4 or 5? 5 to 9, which one? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9? Which one?
And the maximal, so 5 weeks, 5 weeks, 10 weeks, and 4 weeks.
5 weeks, 5 weeks, 10.
And the last is 4 weeks.
Closing don't require 4 weeks. Are you kidding? Okay. There is no clear definition here about your activity, so I could not give you any suggestion. I suggest you look at the other group on how they present their activities. Okay. And look, if this is a real system development project and you put range like this, your proposal will be rejected and you will be humiliated. Okay. You should have exact numbers, not like this. When you put range like this, this is giving the impression that you don't know what you do. Okay, and that's bad if you want to do anything. Okay. If you want to sell something, how much it cost? It's between 10,000 to 12,000. Is it? You should put an exact numbers. Okay. So fix it next time.
Okay,
now for this week, I give you this assignment. This is for group assignment, so it's due next week before the next lecture. You need to describe your progress so far. Means that you need to specify what kind of work you have been done and the contribution of each group member. Okay, so for example, Kenji, what did Kenji do for the whole project? What's his responsibility? Okay, and what he had been done for the last 3 weeks or so, things like that. Okay, it's due next week. Okay, any question about this? Share the screen. Okay, so this is the assignment, yeah, progress report. Describe all your group progress so far. What have you done? What document you have produced? You should include the document that you have produced. Okay. And you need to spell what kind of work you have done. Let me give you this one example. Need to close down first and find my. Just a moment, I'm trying to find the so this is a report that being done for the PNPM project that I mentioned to you on the first lecture. So they report on the performance testing. Okay, so if you can also do this. Okay, so this is the report about performance testing. Can you see the document?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the background or the setting for this report was the developer need to conduct performance testing on their system. So this is on the stages of system development. This is quite late, so this is before the handover, but they did the performance testing. This is a secret document actually. So what they did was, so this is what they did. They checked this server, they checked that server, they checked the log, okay, what they did, and somebody signed on the report. So somebody signed on the report. So they check the alarm, they check the system, they check the temperature, they check the humidity. This is in Indonesia, obviously. They check the air conditioning, things like that. So this is their report, what they did, and who conduct the report. Who conduct the test? Okay, and somebody will sign for them. Okay, so that's the example of the kind of progress report that I want you to create. Okay, you can create a narrative, you can create picture, diagram, tables, or whatever you think will be good for your report. Okay, but I need that kind of report. Okay, any questions?
Yes, sir.
Okay. No? Okay. So let's start our lecture today. It won't be long, hopefully. Okay. Today we will discuss how to identify and select system development project. Okay. As you may remember, that in any organization, there will be plenty of needs to build application information system, buying new computers, buying new laptops, fixing the equipments, replacing the equipments, things like that. Many department, many a division will require new system or fixing the old one or improving the existing system. Plenty of them. So there will be plenty of opportunity and also plenty of requests to develop new system. However, in any organization, there will be limited resources, limited money, limited time, and limited human resource to develop that system. So not all requests, not all proposal will be granted. Not all needs will be fulfilled. organization, companies need to pick which one they need to develop and justify that selection. So this lecture is about that. Okay. This is still on planning stage. We will spend considerable time in planning because this is very important. Although in your case, why in your case I ask you not to spend too many times on planning, because in your case we will make we have make assumption that your proposal is approved, your request is granted, so you can go ahead with just short planning, not the complete planning. Okay. Otherwise, it could be a while to spend times on planning. And moreover, in real practice, the planning will not be done by system analysts. The plan will be done by the management of the company, not by you. Okay. So if they plan to build the best IT system for sales, for example, and then hire you as system analyst to develop that system, they already have planning. So this will be done. Your work will start here based on planning here. So as you can see, that's why in your project management phases, I don't like too many weeks spent on planning, because the assumption is should be done here. Okay, let's continue. So like I said, every stakeholder on the group will bring their own perspective and motivation to identifying potential system development projects. The accounting people will ask for new system. The salespeople will ask new system. IT people, perhaps they will propose some system, things like that. Okay. And sometimes even the owner of the company, the stockholder perhaps, will bring in a new idea. What if we build this? What if we build that? Things like that. Okay, and that's not uncommon in practice. Even when the owner of the company is separated from the management, from time to time they will propose something to change the company, including building a new system. After all, that's their company. Okay. The source could be from top down, identified by top management. That is the case in our class, that you already have the plan handed down by top management, or bottom up. Project initiative that's coming from manager, business unit, or development group. Okay. So it can be from the staff, it can be from the department or anybody but the top management. So the best of breed is there is no best approach. Okay. It depends on what kind of system and how the company itself. Top down may be good for one company but bad for the others. Bottom up may be ideal for one company but very bad for other organizations. Most of the time, companies will be using mix of this approach, top down and bottom up. Okay. Usually, the system that has a strategic or long term impact will be originated from the top management, while the system that related to day to day operation will be originated from managers or business unit or development group. Okay, so that's the difference. If you want to build a system that lasts 10 years, that's usually come from top management. But if the system is just for handling a document that overwhelm payables clerk, then usually it came from that payables clerk. So this is the difference. Okay. Top management will have greater strategic focus, largest project size. Okay. If it's just few millions, development group can handle it. No need to better the top management. But if the project required billions and billions of rupiah, more than a year, that's top management territory. Okay. So how to pick which project proposal should be executed? Which system development proposal should be built and funded? Plenty of way. But if you look at the value chain analysis, value chain is a model from Porter and Miller that showing how a company works. Okay. Let me show you the so like this, what? This simple. Okay. Okay. This. This colorful boxes are the primary activities, while the light green here are the support activities. If a system proposal covering the primary activities, say for production, or for logistics, or for marketing sales, it has higher priority compared to human resource, for example, or accounting. Why? Because here in the light grid, this is just supporting activities. Okay. If you invest in accounting information system here, for example, it will not make your product sell better. It will not make your product better in quality. Okay. But if you spend money here, improving operation, logistic, then it will increase the quality, increase productivity that can be seen immediately. So usually any system proposal that fall into this category will have higher priority, but also it will be much harder to build compared to accounting information system here. Yeah. Okay. So that's value chain. Okay. And this is what I already. So how to select? What's the factor? There are many factors. Okay. First, do you really need that new system, or is it just your perception? Is it real needs or perception? Okay. For example, perception. Say I'm a accounting head department, and I feel plenty of paperwork is overwhelming my department. So I need new automatic system to handle that. Okay. That probably just my perception that I need new system. Why? Because there are too many papers. Well, it may be true, but in many cases, those papers are required and you still need to use papers, then that's not real need, that's just perception. Okay. Real needs, the government imposed, say for example, all the companies in Indonesia using e-invoice, e-factor, for example, electronic invoicing system for tax purposes. Then that's real needs because the government regulation require all companies to use that. So if your company doesn't have that, you need to build one immediately. Okay, so that's perceived ideally. The problem with this part is to differentiate between perception and real. Okay, some might argue that this is real, not just my perception, but that's the way business, and it has to be considered carefully whether this is perception or real needs. Okay. And it's very possible that a company will have ongoing project or list of potential project that will be executed or will be done in a short time. Why we need to consider this? To consider the available resources, existing and available resources here. Because if you still have plenty of project ongoing and plenty of potential project that will be executed in the near future, then available resources might be scarce. Okay, the money is tight, time is unavailable, the people already engaged in other projects, so it's need to be considered carefully. Current organizational environment. Okay. In many places, let me give you an example of the government of Indonesia. Okay. The government of Indonesia has been many years try to automate the procurement system. How the government institution, the government organizations like the local government, dinas, for example, in buying product and services. Okay, they want to automate that for the whole Indonesia. Unfortunately, in the past, it cannot be done immediately. Why? Because especially in eastern part of Indonesia, the infrastructure required for building automatic procurement system like e-catalog is difficult. Electricity and telecommunication were problems. So they could not build fully automatic system there. Okay. And even if they have electricity and connection, the quality of connection and the quality of electricity supply is not were not good, that it could not be online 24 hours, for example. Different from if you build the system in Java, okay, in Java Island, that won't be a problem. Okay, and that's a environment. Okay, you want to build. Many years ago, I heard this story that we probably heard it from me, perhaps. There was a donor organization that want to help students in Papua to have modern education. So they make a survey and they found out that many schools, primary schools, middle schools, high schools in Papua, they don't have proper computer labs. Okay. While this organization wants to help students in Papua, especially the rural area, to have advanced and high technology education. So they proposed to build a computer lab and did it. They built a new building for computer labs. They buy desk equipment, decent computers, not the best, but decent computers. So it's completely built and it was great. So that was the time to officiate the use of the computer labs. The head of the donor organization was planned to fly from the US to Indonesia to officiate the computer lab, but then it was postponed. Why? Because apparently nobody told them that the location where the computer lab and the school situated, they don't have electricity. Okay, so that's a huge mistake in planning. Let me show you this. Okay. This is okay. Oh, sorry. Okay. It's been okay. So this is a project called One Laptop Per Child. Okay. Not this one. This is okay. Okay. It was started like 20 years ago in the early 2000. Okay. If you look at it, this laptop is very portable. Okay. Small, okay. It has Wi-Fi antenna here. It's small. The storage is just like 4 gigabytes or something. It's pale compared to your current mobile phone. This laptop was designed for children, school children in Africa, in sub-Sahara Africa. Okay. So this is designed for them. If you look at this crank here, this is specifically designed for this laptop because there is no electricity in the intended location. Okay. So the company that built it, it's not the company, it's organization that built it was the idea for this laptop was came from Nicolas Negroponte. Nicolas Negroponte at that time was the head of Media Lab in Massachusetts Institute of Technology. So they knew that in the villages that they want to share to distribute this laptop, they didn't have electricity, so they built this. This is a hand crank generator to charge the battery. Okay, and they also understand that the village doesn't have telephone cable, so they built Wi-Fi here. You see that there is a USB port here and also for headset and mic. And then they will provide Wi-Fi access for the students. So this is an example of system design, not only the hardware, not only the laptop, but also the supporting like Wi-Fi and electricity, that considering the environment. Okay. So then you also will create evaluation criteria. For example, we will discuss later in other lecture about, and you probably remember this from your accounting information system, feasibility study. Does the proposed project will have passed the feasibility study? Does the cost less than the benefit, smaller than the benefit? Does the benefit? Is it technically feasible? Is it legally feasible? Is it schedule feasible? And things like that. Okay. So the decision of the project selection would be first accept the project. There is available resources, that's the real need. It will not interfere with the potential or ongoing project. The current organizational environment support this proposal, and also it pass all the criteria. It's feasible, for example. Second, reject the project. Okay. There is no resources available, it's not real needs, it will interfere with the ongoing projects, it doesn't fit the current environment, and also it doesn't pass the evaluation. So reject the project, okay, forget about it. Third, delay the project. Okay, it seems fine, but probably it passed all the evaluation criteria, but probably there is no available resources right now. It will be available next year, so we can start the project next year. Or the schedule probably interfere with the ongoing project. Okay, so delay that until next week, next year perhaps. Refocus the project. So some aspect of the project, say for example the cost maybe, or the fit with organizational event, it doesn't really fit with the overall organization. So we need to refocus the project. For example, many years ago, a lot of company built system use based on a BlackBerry. Okay. Nowadays, if you propose to build a system with a BlackBerry as a device, that would be automated rejection. However, if the system itself is good, but the BlackBerry part is bad, then you can just refocus that. Instead of using BlackBerry, you can use iPhone or Android, for example. So that's refocus the project. And user development, it means that, well, doesn't really concern the whole organization. It's just for your department, so you can build it yourself. That's end user. As long as it doesn't interfere with the whole system, the organizational system, you can develop it. Okay. proof of concept. This is proof of concept is just like an experiment or a small sample or pilot project, if you will. This usually involve with a system that will be very big, the system that will be affecting the whole organization. In national, for example, a few years ago, the Indonesian government tried to move. I said before about the procurement system. Sorry. The government of Indonesia trying to to centralize the procurement system like e-catalog and things like that to the national level. So instead of each regency, each city have their or each province have their own system, it will be hosted in Jakarta for the whole nation. Just thinking of Gmail for procurement. So instead of each regency or city or province have their own system, they just use one national system that being hosted in Jakarta. And at that time, the technology is there. The cloud system is already popular and it has been done, and many of other companies or and many other government in the world has already utilized cloud system for their governmental system. However, the problem with at that time was the Indonesian government at that time doesn't have experience in developing cloud system. Okay, this is not cloud like Amazon or Google Cloud or Microsoft Azure, not like that. But this is a private cloud, private Indonesian cloud. So the government of Indonesia has to build their own cloud system. Why? Because this is governmental system. There are plenty of, well, not secret, but confidential information that should not be known by other people. So they just did. So because of cloud system involve significant amount of investment, probably a trillion instead of billion, the government need proof that it could work. So they want a proof of concept. They want a proof in a smaller system that it could work. So that's why it's proof of concept. So if the proof of concept work, then they can escalate the project into the bigger proportion. But if not, fail, you have to stop it. Okay. Okay, so this is our identifier project. We will have this. This is actually has been covered in financial management, so I will not cover that in depth. So basically with a scoring system, you assign score and then you create like this, for example, this one. Okay, so rating score, and then at the end, okay, you pick the alternative with the highest score. In this case, this is the alternative C with 430. Okay. Okay, so like I said, it's in business, it's not like white and black, no and yes. Okay, most of the time is yes but or no but. Okay, so there is a strategy to make the proposal can be accepted, which is starting from small. Okay, starting from one phase, and then if that succeeds, it's continue to the next phase. It's also incremental commitment. Why? Because first, probably the investment or the cost for that project is too much, and you want proof. Sorry. Okay, so it starts with advance and we succeed and it's look good, we can continue the next and the next and the next and so on and so forth. Okay, so that's the thing. Okay, I will not cover this because this has been covered plenty in MIS. Okay, strategy, things like that, information system planning, this is already been covered in MIS. Okay, so that's how you select which information system development project being considered and pick one that will be executed. Okay. Again, every company, every organization will have different priority. Okay. And sometimes it will change by the time. For example, if you remember our kuliah site, before we were forced to work from home, school study from home with this pandemic, the kuliah site was not really well. Let me just say the development of kuliah site is not a priority. But then after we were forced to study from home and almost all of the lecturers and also students use kuliah site, it was evidence that the kuliah site was unable to cope with that burden, with that heavier workload than usual. So they start to fix that. Okay, nowadays it's better because we also have other tools, which is Microsoft Teams, to lessen the burden on kuliah site. But still, what the kuliah site that was not a priority now become priority because of the situation, because of the environment. Okay, so that's how it works in business. One day it's not a priority, the next day it will be. Okay. And a lot of company also facing the problems. Just last week, I read that Netflix, for example, although they were forced to work from home due to the pandemics, the CEO think that this is not a good idea. Okay, why? Because they were not prepared. However, because of the pandemic, they have to prepare, and they now trying to fix the problems that surface because of working from home. Okay, any question so far? Anybody want to clarify something or to ask questions?
Sir, I want to ask about the assignment, sir.
Okay, sure. Go ahead.
The assignment for the next week is like the example to use sound. Did you shown to us, or the report is like you shown to us, or we can use another
okay. I just show you an example. Okay, I don't think because the example that I shown you was for a later stage of system development, it won't be fit to your situation. Okay, I just show you an example of what I meant. Okay, but obviously you are welcome to use your own format, layout, or reporting style. Okay, the main thing that I ask you to present in your report is the progress, the work that you have been done, and contribution of each group member. That's it. No more, no less. Is that clear?
Okay. If there's like progress only 50% or 70%, it's result.
No. I don't want you to give any percentage. Okay. We will discuss that later. Okay. How to estimate the progress, but not now. Okay. What I want you to show me is the work that you have been done. No matter, it doesn't matter whether it's 10%, 20%, 15%, doesn't matter. I want the description of work that you have been done. Not valuation, not percentage.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
And then for the project management phase, it's should be we do the revise and submit to you or not, sir?
Okay, you have to revise it. That's for sure. But at this time, you don't need to submit it. Later, you will use that project management phases for more detailed plan. For example, somebody said about the planning will be 2 weeks. Okay. Then you need later on, you need to create a detailed activities day to day, hour to hour even on those 2 weeks. And that's based on project management phase that you already did, and then you have to revise. Okay, it will be used, but not now. Okay, but I suggest you to revise that as soon as possible.
Okay, thank you, sir.
So, okay, no worries. So for all of you, this part of assignment that I give you, it will be used and reused and reused again. Okay. So it will be all your assignment will be a continuation of the previous assignment. Okay. That's why I ask you to revise your project management phase, because you will use that for detailed project and later on budget. Okay. So you need to prepare to put numbers on those activities, like for example planning, how much money required for planning, how many people required for planning. Okay. What's the specification of people you want to hire for development, for example? How many programmers, how many database specialists if necessary? Do you need to buy any hardware? Do you need to rent or lease any software? Things like that. Get prepared for that. But that will be developed based on the project management phase. And you have to start looking at prices. For example, if you want to buy servers, how much money to buy servers that needed? If you want to rent a laptop, how many laptops, the specification, how much money to rent that laptop, things like that. Okay, so get prepared. Find information about that, but you will need it for the future assignments. Okay, any other questions?
Sir, just want to confirm. So for the next assessment, so for example, the activity that we have been done, such as identify the business like that, sir, or?
Yeah, well, just describe everything that you have been done until next week. Okay, and describe it as detailed as possible, because this is a progress report. Look, why I required you to create progress report, because in reality, plenty of project management, information system development project, the developer, the system analyst will be paid based on the work that have been done. Okay, so for examples, I finish database design. I report that progress to the client. The client approve the design, then I will get paid. If the client doesn't approve that design, I won't get paid. That's why usually progress report, when accepted, will be trigger for payment. Okay, and that's plenty of project, information system development project, being done like that. You'll get paid when you finish a stage. That's why I want you to create progress report from time to time. Okay. So think of progress report, like you report what you have done because you want to ask for money. Look, I've already create a project management phases, for example. This is the project management phases. Pay me. Okay. So that's why I required you to create progress report. Is that clear?
Okay, sir, it's clear. Thank you.
Okay, no worries. Any other questions? Okay. If there is no question, I'll stop the lecture now, and I'll consider there will be no mini assignment today. So I will consider all of you here that attend this online class to be attend. Next week we will have you presenting your progress report. Okay, so next week for our lecture we will have online meeting like this, but instead of me giving you speech, you and your group will present the progress. Okay, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
sir,
good.
So we must make some PowerPoint to present our progress.
It's up to you.
Okay.
It's up to you. But remember, this in real life, the presentation will be used to decide whether or not the client will pay you. So go ahead and think about the best strategy for presenting your progress.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, so that's it for today. See you next week. And get prepared for presenting your progress.